After the discussion of the external auditory canal, today we are going to discuss about the major clinical important thing in the external auditory canal, or the clinically important portion of the external auditory canal, that is fissures of Fandorini. Right? What is it? As we know that after the pinna there is a tube like structure called that we called the portion of the external ear, that is external auditory canal or external auditory tube extending from the bottom of the concha to the tympanic membrane. This external auditory canal is further divided into the initial 8 mm portion is called the cartilaginous part, and the next 16 mm is called the bony part, right? So the fissures of Fandorini lies in the cartilaginous part. So what is fissures of Fandorini? As we see, it lies in the cartilaginous part of the external auditory canal, or the initial segment of the external auditory canal, right? In the consider it as the cartilage segment. In the cartilage segment, there lies in the anteroinferior portion of the cartilage segment, there lies a deficiency of cartilage. Such deficiencies are called fissures of Fandorini. So what is fissures of Fandorini? The deficiencies of anteroinferior portion of the cartilaginous part of the external auditory canal is called fissures of Fandorini. Then how it clinically important? First one, as we said, it lies in the anteroinferior portion of the fissures of the cartilaginous part of the external auditory canal. The part or the portion that lies inferior to the cartilaginous part of the external auditory canal is parotid. On the anterior portion and mastoid on the posterior portion, right? So the infections from the anteroinferior part, that is parotid from the anterior and the mastoid, majorly superior mastoid infections, are enters into the transferred into the cartilaginous part of the external auditory canal through these deficiencies called fissures of Fandorini. It can be occur also as vice versa, that is infection from the external auditory canal or the cartilaginous part of the external auditory canal can be transferred into the parotid gland and mastoid through these fissures. That gives the importance of these deficiencies called fissures of Fandorini.